Hello everyone, and welcome to this very first video about mechanical vibrations. My name is Jernan Schilder, and I'm a lecturer in mechanical engineering at the University of Twente. At this moment, however, the university is closed because of the coronavirus outbreak. And I am supposed to teach a course called Dynamics 2 in the next quartile, which is about mechanical vibrations. Most likely we will not do this live, but I have to digitalize my my lectures. And since there are so many lectures, I can only manage this if I start right away. So I thought, okay, if I'm going to do this, I might as well make these lectures publicly available anyway, because, well, it might be that not only my students, but more people like to learn something about mechanical vibrations. I can imagine that that's the case if you already watched all the series in this period of social distancing. So what I'm going to do, first of all, I will explain you how I will deal with this this course. I will make some video lectures, pencast actually, on my iPad. So I will write down all the derivations and all the examples that I would normally do in a live lecture. And I will post these online. And I will do this in blocks that correspond to a certain theme or to a certain chapter. And in between these blocks, I will do a video like this where I explain the basic thoughts of the next block. So in this first video, I would like you to explain what mechanical vibrations is about. It's a special branch within engineering dynamics. The lecture series is intended for second year bachelor students in mechanical engineering, but normally we have students from a wide variety of other study programs joining in as well. So think about industrial design engineering, advanced technology, applied physics, biomedical engineering, things like this. So feel free to join these lecture series. I will assume as pre-knowledge that you have heard of Newton's second law, and you will require some basic math skills. So differentiation and integration of standard functions. We will need a bit of linear algebra and eigenvalue problems, as well as differential equations and how to solve that. Now, if math is not really your strong point, don't panic. I will go through it step by step. And I will also make some additional videos, in particular for differential equations, to explain you how to deal with that. So let me maybe first start off by what is this course about? Why would we study mechanical vibrations? The purpose of it is that we are going to discover analytical techniques with which we are able to simulate, to solve how complicated mechanical systems or structures or machines, mechanisms, are behaving as a function of time if they are externally loaded. So maybe there are forces applying, acting on this system. How is the system going to move? So how is it going to move is the key question here. And we would like to do this because sometimes we are just interested in the motion of a system in general. But also we are interested typically in whether or not a machine or a structure will fail. What are the internal stresses? What are the deformations? And if we do this all in a static way, in many, many cases, we are underestimating the internal stresses. So if we want to have a good prediction of internal stresses and the risks that come with that, we need to be able to solve problems in a dynamic fashion. And in particular with vibrations, there are all sorts of risks like resonance or fatigue that are specifically related to these dynamics. So we are going to discover in this course techniques with which we are able to solve for the motion of a system as a function of time analytically. Yeah, so we only need a pen and paper for this course. Now, I would say that in this procedure, there are basically two stages. The first stage is about how can we set up the governing equation, the so-called equation of motion that describes the motion of a system. So this is a differential equation, and given the system, we should be able to set up this equation of motion. So finding this equation, that will be the first part of our journey. And the second part is then on how to solve this equation. Okay, so I think these are clearly two distinct phases. Now, each of these phases has two subphases. And for the derivation of the equation of motion, first we will look into what is called the kinematics, and second, the kinetics. So slightly a different name. With kinematics, we refer to geometry and math that we need to describe the motion. So we look at the system from a distance, we see that it moves, and we are just wondering how can we mathematically describe what we see. And for that, we will introduce a coordinate frame, we'll introduce coordinates and relations in between these coordinates. So this is all kinematics, just describing mathematically what we see using coordinates. Then this second subphase, the kinetics, is actually including the physics. So that is where we will use Newton's second law, which basically describes the relation between the forces acting on a system and the motion. It relates forces to accelerations. So that's the second part. And at the end of it, we will have a set of equations, or just one equation for simple systems, where which describes the motion and the relation between forces and motion. Okay, then in solving the equation of motion, we can also distinguish two flavors, let's say. The first one is what we will call free vibrations. And these are problems when we have a system and consider that for some reason, for whatever reason, the system is removed from its equilibrium state. So it's not at rest, but maybe initially there is an initial velocity, or we just move it and release. And then from a distance, we watch how it moves and maybe how it damps out. So we will not consider any other external forces except for this initial disturbance. Okay, these are called free vibrations. And on the other side, we have what is called forced vibrations. And these are vibrations that are really induced by external forces. And we have to study what is the effect of these external forces on the motion of the system. Okay, so these are the two types of vibration that we are going to look into, and also the combined effect we will discuss. Then we will do so for two different kind of systems. The first type of systems that we will look into are so-called rigid multibody systems. So these systems consist maybe of multiple components, but we will assume that each component can be considered as rigid. So it will not deform. This is of course some idealization. It's not in reality everything can deform, but for some systems this is a very good approximation. So we will do that first. And then later on in the second half of this course, we will look into flexible systems. So systems that can actually deform. Now, in some terms that are related to this, the rigid multibody systems are sometimes called discrete systems, as the number of degrees of freedom is a finite number, and the flexible systems are sometimes referred to as continuous systems, because typically mass is distributed in a continuous way, the number of degrees of freedom is infinite, and we really need to look into how do we describe the deformation of such a system. And we will do that for things like bars in torsion, or shafts in torsion, or beams in bending, these kind of problems. Okay, so that is, I would say, in general, a general introduction in how the course is set up. We will start with the discussion of discrete systems, so systems with in which all components are rigid. And we will start by the kinematic analysis. So the I will try to make these pencasts that I will make on my iPad. I will try to keep this video short, so I aim for like 15 minutes max, in which I will either do some theory or some example. And for the kinematics, I need four video lectures, in order to explain the basic things on how to describe what kind of coordinates we need, how they are related to each other, and these kind of things. So after this video, I will post these four video lectures on kinematics, and after that, I will do a video like this to introduce you to the next topic. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked the lectures. If you have any questions, let me know. Put it in the comments or so, or find another way to ask this question. I hope you like it. Have some fun with Dynamics. It's really nice. And I will see you in the next video. Okay, thanks.